Hello everybody. So today we will learn design of RCC T beam slab bridge. Okay, so these are the given data. Clear width of the carriageway is given 7.5 meter. Then span is 16 meter, center to center of bearing, and dimension of the curve on either side of the road is 600 mm × 300 mm. And live load IRC class A tracked vehicle. Thickness of the wearing port is 80 mm, grade of concrete M25, grade of steel is Fe415. Okay. So, before starting the design, we should know what are the different components in a T-beam slab bridge. So, basically, in this type of bridges, we'll have three components. We have to design all these three components separately. So what are the components? Number one, deck slab. Number two, longitudinal girder. This is also known as main girder. Then number three, cross girder. So let's say this design of deck slab, design of deck slab that can be done by using Piggott's curve. Okay, so by using this Piggott's curve, we will calculate the moment coefficient. Okay, then we can calculate the bending moment required for the deck slab. Then number two, second one is your longitudinal girder. So to design this longitudinal girder, there are three different types of methods are there. Number one, Corbin's method. Number two, Guyon-Maisonet method. Number three, Henry Jaeger method. So out of these three, this one is the simplest one, so we will use this method to design the longitudinal girder. Okay, and also the cross girder. So actually this method you can be used, there are certain specifications to use this method. Your span to width ratio of the deck should be within 2 to 4. Okay. Number 2, second criteria, the longitudinal girder should interconnected by at least 5 symmetrically placed cross girder. Okay. And number 3, the CG should extend to a depth of at least 0.75, the depth of longitudinal girder. ओके सो इफ वी टॉक अबाउट दिस क्लास ए ए ट्रैक्ट व्हीकल फॉर क्लास ए ए ट्रैक्ट व्हीकल लेट्स से द सेक्शन ऑफ ए TBM slab bridge. So these are the longitudinal girders. Okay. So the distance between the two girder is dx, and these are the two wheels. Class A track braking. Okay. So this will be W, and this will be W. So this will be the resultant force at the medial. And as we know, this thickness of the wheelbase is 850 mm. That is 0.85. This is 0.85. Okay. So let's say this is the CG. Suppose this is the center of gravity. Okay. So if this is the center of gravity, then what will be the eccentricity? This will be the eccentricity, distance from CG to the resultant loading, that is E. And this thing, we know that this distance should be at least 1.2 meter. This is for class AA tracked vehicle. Okay, so if this is the case, then the reaction factors in Corbin's method, we will calculate the reaction factors. Okay, so this Rx, this is there is an expression, is equal to 1 plus summation of I divided by summation of dx square dot I into dx into E. So in this expression, this Rx is, this is the reaction factor. This is the reaction factor for the girder under consideration. And I is the moment of inertia. Longitudinal order. And what is dx? Dx will be the distance of the girder under consideration from the central axis of the bridge. Okay, so here this is the central axis of the bridge. W is the total concentrated light load. Then N is number of longitudinal girder and E is the eccentricity of the life load with respect to the axis of the bridge. Okay, so this is how we can calculate the reaction factor which will be used in designing of longitudinal girder and cross girder. So let's start this problem. So before designing a T-beam slab bridge, we have to assume certain things. Let's assume the width of width of the longitudinal girder is equal to 300 mm. Then depth of the deck slab 200 mm. And number of longitudinal girder is 3. So there are 3 number of longitudinal girders spaced at a depth of 2.5 meters center to center. There are 5 number of cross girders spaced at a depth of 4 meters center to center. So let's draw this figure. So these 3 are the longitudinal guard. Okay. And the spacing between this 2 center to center, we have assumed this 2.5 meter. This is also 2.5 meter. Then this width of each longitudinal girder, we have assumed how much? 300 mm. And thickness of the deck slab we have assumed 200 mm. Then wearing thickness of wearing coat, this is given. Thickness of wearing coat, this is given 80 mm. Then carriageway, width of carriageway, this one, this is given 7.5 meter. Okay. And curve dimension 300 cross 600. So this is 600 and this is 300 mm. Okay, so these are all the dimensions. So if you draw the plan view, this is the sectional view. If you draw the plan view, it can be like this. Okay, there are 8 number of panels. So these are the this distance between this. This is how much? This is 2.5 meter. This is 2.5 meter. So these are the longitudinal border. Okay, longitudinal girder. 3 number of longitudinal girder space between 2.5 meter center to center. And these are the 5 number of cross girder. So these are the cross girder. So 5 number of cross girders are there, spaced between 4 meter center to center. This is 4 meter. This is 4 meter. This is 4 meter. Okay. And this thickness of the cross girder is also 300 mm. Okay. And this is also thickness of longitudinal girder is also 300 mm. So of 8 number of panels are there. So we will design a single panel. A single panel we will design. This is one panel. So first is your design of deck slab. Design of deck slab. First component is our deck slab. So as you know, there are 3 number of longitudinal girders at a rate of 2.5 mm center to center spacing. Then thickness of the slab we have assumed 200 mm. Width of longitudinal girder 300 mm. Width of cross girder also 300 mm. Now let's assume the depth of main girder or the longitudinal girder is equal to 1600 mm. Actually this length you have to assume by considering for 1 meter span you can assume 10 cm. So here the span length is, what is the span length in our case? I think 16 meter. The span length is 16 meter. So if the span length is 16 meter, for 16 meter span the assumed depth will be 160 cm, which is equal to 1600 mm. Okay. Okay, so the depth of the main girder is 1600 mm. That is this distance. Depth of the main girder will be from here to here. This is 1600 mm that we have assumed. Okay. Now calculation of bending moment. So we will consider a single panel and we will calculate the required bending moment. For a single panel. Calculation of bending moment for a single panel. So single panel means this will be the V is 2.5 meter and length will be 4 meter. Okay. So we'll calculate the dead load and live load. So let's calculate the dead load first. Dead load of the slab is equal to 24 into width is 200 mm, we have assumed. So this is 4.8 kilonewton per meter square. then your weight of the wearing coat 22, unit weight of your bitumen into thickness is 80 mm, so 0.08, 1.76 kilonewton per meter square. So the total dead load of the slab will be 4.8 plus 1.76, so total 6.56 kilonewton per meter square. Let's this is WD, dead load. This stands for dead load. So if you calculate the dead load, this is 6.58 kilonewton per meter square. So over which area this is acting? 2.5 meter and 4 meter. So 2.5 into 4 is equal to 65.6 kilonewton. So you converted this into the concentrated load of 65.6 kilonewton. Let's this is capital W. Okay. Now we'll find out the dispersion width of the vehicle. Dispersion width of the vehicle. So let's say if it was a figure, this is the thickness of the wearing coat. So this is 80 mm. This is the wheel load 850 mm. So dispersion will occur like this, 45 degree angle. So dispersion width will be from here to here. This one, this is the dispersion width denoted as U. Okay, so what will be this length? This is 850, so let's calculate. U is equal to dispersion width of the vehicle, which can be this is 850 from here to here. This is 850 plus here 80, here 80. So this is 850 plus 80 plus 80, so 0.85 in meter plus 2 times 0.08, which is equal to 1.01 meter. Similarly, in other direction it will be center to center distance between two wheel for class AA tracked vehicle is almost 3.6. So here we will take this 3.6 plus 2 times 0.08, which is equal to 3.76 meter. Okay, so if let's say this is the dispersion area, so this will be your U and this will be your V. Okay, so that we have calculated. So next, so what we have calculated, this is for your live load. This is for live load. If you take the dead load, for dead load what will be the dispersion? This is 4 meter and this is 2.5 meter. So for dead load you have to consider the total panel. The total panel is carrying the load. So for this case, V is equal to U and L is equal to V. So U is equal to V is equal to 2.5 meter and V is equal to L is equal to 4 meter. Okay, this is for your dead load. Okay. Because here the total panel is taking the load. So now so how to use this Pigard's curve? Pigard's curve. So these are the curves like this. So in the x-axis you can see here, this is the ratio of u by b. Okay. And in y-axis this is v by l. So so from this curve we will get this moment coefficient m1 and m2. Okay, moment coefficient m1 and m2 for this k is equal to 0.1. What is k? K is the ratio of b by l. So in our case b is 2.5 and l is 4. So we have to calculate the k value, and accordingly we have to use this Pigard's curve. So we here we have a different curves for different k value. So this curve is for k is equal to 0.1. similarly you can see here, this is for k is equal to 0.5, this is 0.6. okay, so from this curve we will get this coefficient m1 into 100. Okay, and from this b curve we will get m2 into 100. Similarly here, for k is equal to 0.5, the coefficient m1 into 100, and from second curve we will get m2 into 100. This is another for k value 0.4. this is another for k value 0.8. okay, this is for k value 0.8, this is for k value 0.7. so for different values of k we have to refer different Pigard's curve. So first we'll calculate the k value in our case. What is the k value in our case? K is equal to v divided by l, is equal to 2.5 by 4, is 0.625. okay, so it is 0.625. so what will be the here we are calculating the dead load bending moment. Calculation of bending moment for this panel. So for dead load and live load separately we'll calculate. So first calculate for dead load. So for dead load, what is the u by b ratio? K value is 0.625 and ratio of u by b is 1 and ratio of v by l is 1. Okay, this is for dead load. So next we have to refer the Pigard's curve versus 0.6. so 0.6 is 0.4. so this one, second one, 0.6. so what will be the value of m1 and m2? So for this lower one, lower right, will give you this m1, and upper right will give you m2 for u by v 1 and v by l 1. So you can check the corresponding value. It is around this is 5, so it can be, we can take this as 0.49. so that corner one, so it can be taken as 4.9. So 4.9 means this is m1 into 100. m1 into 100 is 4.9. so what will be m1? 4.9 by 100. So 0.049. similarly from here, the corresponding value of 1 and 1, this is 2. This is 2 means it can be 1.5. okay, it can be 1.5, the corner one, it can be 1.5. okay, this one. So here I can write from the Pigard's curve we can get M1 into 100 is equal to 4.9 and M2 into 100 is equal to 1.5. Okay, so the value of M1 will be 0.049 and value of M2 will be 0.015. Okay, so next we'll calculate the spending moment MB. That is equal to, how to calculate the bending moment using this curve. The bending moment will be load into M1 plus mu into M2. What is mu? Mu is the Poisson's ratio. Mu is the Poisson's ratio, which is for concrete 0.15. So what is the loading? Loading we have calculated, we are calculating for dead load. So loading we have already calculated, how much? 65.6. So this is 65.6 into M1 0.049 plus mu into M2 0.015. So let's calculate this. So it will be around 3.362 kilonewton meter. Similarly, what would be ML in length direction? Same, the load into M2, just the reverse, M2 into mu into M1. So 65.6 plus 0.015 plus 0.15 into 0.049. So this is equal to 61.466 kilonewton meter. So again, here we have to see, we have calculated for a single panel, but this is not a single panel, this is continuous. So we have to consider another factor here. Known as continuity effect. Considering the effect of continuity, this moment, it will be reduced by 20%. So we will take 80%. So my MB will be, considering the effect of continuity, MB will be 0.8 times 3.362, which is equal to 2.688 kilonewton meter, and ML is 0.8 into 1.466, which is equal to 1.174 kilonewton meter. Okay, so this is the final bending moment due to dead load. Second, what is the shear force? Shear force due to dead load. That will be WL/2, so WD into L/2 is 6.56 kilonewton per meter square into, we have to multiply the clear span here. L will be how much? 2.5 minus 0.3 divided by 2. Okay. So here you can, this is one panel, it will be continuous. So this is 2.5, so you have to take from here to, this is 2.5 from here to here. So we will consider this only, this part. So it will be 2.5 minus, this is how much? 0.3, 300 mm thick. So 2.5 minus 0.3 by 2 minus 0.3 by 2. So I can write 2.5 minus 0.3. So this is equal to 7.26 kilometer. Then number 3, calculation of bending moment due to live load. This is your dead load. This is dead load. So you have calculated, till now we have calculated the dead load bending moment and the dead load shear force. So next we will calculate the live load bending moment. So same, we will use the Piggott's curve. So U by B we have already calculated how much? U we have calculated 1.01 for live load divided by 2.5 is equal to 0.404. Then V by L is equal to 3.76 divided by 4, this is 0.94. And K value is V by L is 2.5 by 4, so 0.625. So now from the Piggott's curve, the corresponding value of 0.404 and 0.94. First M1, 0.404 and here 0.404 and 0.9. So it will be around 8.5. okay, and M2 will be around 2.4. in it will be between 2 and 3. So let's take 2.4. So from the Piggott's curve, this M1 into 100 we got 8.5 and M2 into 100 we got 2.4. So what will be M1? 0.085. and what will be M2? 0.024. Now we'll calculate MB and MN. MB will be W into M1 plus mu M2. So what is W? 350 kilonewton. This is the live load, class A tracked vehicle. This is your class AA tracked vehicle. So 350 into M1, 0.085 plus 0.15 into 0.024. So this is equal to 31.01 kilonewton meter. Similarly, in other direction, 350 into just the reverse one, 0.024 plus 0.15 into 0.085. So this is equal to 12.86 kilonewton meter. Now we will consider, so this is the live load, so here you have to consider the continuity effect as well as the impact factor, impact effect. In dead load case we will consider only the continuity effect, but here we have to consider the both continuity effect and impact effect. Okay. So what will be the MB? Will be 31.01 into 0.8 for continuity effect, will reduced by 20%, into what is the impact effect? Impact effect, you have to multiply the impact factor, that you will get from IRC 6. So for this span of 16 meter, you can refer this IRC 6. The impact factor will be 1.1. It will increase by 10%. So this is the continuity and this is the impact effect. This one you will get from IRC 6. It will increase by 10%, given in page number 25. Okay. So you can check this. So this is coming 27.29 kilonewton meter, and ml is equal to 12.86 into 0.8 into 1.1, which is equal to 11.32 kilonewton meter. So this is the mv and this is ml. This is the live load bending moment. What will be the live load shear force? Shear force due to live load. Shear force due to live load. So to calculate this, first you have to place the wheel load so that we can get the maximum shear force. So to get this maximum shear force value, the wheel load should be placed, it should be placed such that the whole dispersion is in the span. So if we draw the figure, let's say this is continuous, this is the width, this is 0.85, so there will be dispersion, this is the center line. There will be dispersion like this. Okay. So this length is 2.5 meter, and this center to center will be 2.5 minus 0.3 by 2 minus 0.3 by 2 is equal to 2.2 meter. This is 2.2 meter, and this width, you know, this is 200 and this is 80 mm. This is 80 mm. So if this is taken as x, this is taken as x, then your x will be how much? X will be how much? So this is the dispersion width. This is the dispersion width that we can calculate. First you have to calculate that, and this x value will be this divided by 2. X will be dispersion width divided by 2. So before that we have to calculate the dispersion. So dispersion in the direction of span. Be equal to how much? 0.85 plus 2 times 0.2 plus 0.08. Okay. So this will be, this is 0.85. So to consider this. This is 45 degree, so this will be 200 plus 80. this will be 200 plus 80 plus this is 850. So we can calculate, that is coming 1.41 meter. So x will be 1.41 by 2, which is equal to 0.705 meter. And what is the effective width of the slab? Effective width of the slab, that is B effective. Okay, actually this is this one you can say the effective length, not width. This is length, this question length in the direction of span. And what is the effective width? Effective width will be as per the IRC 21, this is alpha A into 1 minus A by L plus B1. This is as per IRC 21, page number 52. You can check this. Okay. So let's calculate alpha. This depends upon the ratio of B by L. So what is this? B by L is equal to, B will be 4 minus 0.3 by 2 minus 0.3 by 2 divided by 2.5 minus 0.3 by 2 minus 0.3 by 2. This is equal to 3.7 by 2.2, which is equal to 1.681. The corresponding value of alpha for B is equal to 1.681. Value of alpha from table you can check IRC 21. Okay, so this is page number 52, so you can check this. So for 1.681, this is 1.6, this is 1.7. So for 1.6, this is 2.52, and this is continuous slab. And for 1.7, this is 2.56. So we have to interpolate. We want 1.68. What will be the value for 1.68? So we have to get this value by linear interpolation. So for 1.6 this value is 2.52, for 1.7 this value is 2.56. So what will be the value for 1.681? So you can interpolate, we will get 2.55 from linear interpolation. This is your table number, the page number 53. Okay. And then what will be this B1? B1 will be 3.6 as per the code. 2 into 0.08 is 3.76 meter. Now what is A? A is the distance from CG to the, this is the distance from CG to the nearer support. So that will be equal to 0.705 meter that we have calculated. X is equal to 0.705. So now we can calculate the B effective, which is equal to alpha, that is 2.55 into A 0.705 into 1 minus 0.705 divided by L 2.2 plus 3.76. So this one will get 4.98 meters. Let's take 5. But okay. So we are calculating for live load. What will be the load per, or you can write the live load per unit width. Live load per unit width. The total loading divided by B effective, that is 350 divided by 5, is equal to 70 kilonewton per meter. So 70 kilonewton per meter. So this thing, let's say this is one's longitudinal girder, this is another, so this is the cross girder. So this is the loading, 70 kilonewton per meter. Okay, so this distance between two is 2.2 meter, and from CG to this is 0.705. So what will be the if let's say this is V, so what will be the V? You can write V into 2.2 is equal to, by taking moment about this, so this is A, this is V, by taking moment about V to 0, so V into 2.2 minus 70, this minus this, so 70 into 2.2 into, sorry, 70 into 2.2 minus 0.705 is equal to 0. So what will be V, you can calculate, will be 47.6 kilo. Now considering the effect of impact, this V will be reduced. 47.6 into 1.1 is equal to 52.3 kilonewton. So next we will calculate the design moment and design shear force. Design, or you can say the factor moment or design moment, and factor or design shear force. Okay, so in both the direction we have calculated this M BU. U stands for ultimate or design, and M LU. Or you can write D, ML, D. So what is MBD? Here we have to take the factor of safety. So the factor of safety for dead load is taken as 1.35, and for live load it is taken as 1.5. So you can refer, so that is given in IRC 6. Okay, so you can go for this IRC 6 page number 93, table number B2, is the partial safety factor for verification of structural strength. Okay, so this is permanent load, that is the dead load, is taken as 1.35, and for live load or variable load it is taken as 1.5. Table B2, page number 93, IRC 6. This is for factor of safety. So for MV, this is 1.35 into MB live load plus 1.5 into MB. So this is dead load, this is live load. This is equal to So dead load moment, how much you have calculated? 1.35 you can say plus 1.5 into 1.5 into live load, dead load moment in other direction. It is 2.689, which is equal to 2.689. So live load we have calculated 27.29. The total will be 44.56 kilonewton meter. Similarly, in other direction, lengthwise, right, the designed load 1.35 ml dead plus 1.5 ml live. So this is 1.35 into this one is 7.0. Dead load moment in L direction. This is 1.174. 1.174 plus 1.5 into live load 11.319. So this is coming 88.25 kilonewton meter. Shear force ultimate for design shear force 1.35 into DVD plus 1.5 VBL. So 1.35 into 7.26 for dead load plus 1.5 into 52.3 for live load. So is equal to 88.25 kilonewton. So out of this two, which is maximum, we will consider this moment for this one. This one will be kilonewton. So we'll have to consider this maximum 44.56 MD. So for shear force of 88.25 kilonewton and bending moment of 44.56, we have to design the deck slab. So the next step is design of deck slab.